Fellow Zimbabweans and Africans at large, we'd like to thank you for the solidarity that you've shown to our beautiful motherland, Zimbabwe, at a time when we're facing a protest, at a time when we're mourning the death of our musical icon, Dr. Oliver Mtukudzi, may your soul rest in power, at a time when we're united as 30 million people in the fight against sanctions. Specific mention goes to Comrade Cyril Ramaphosa. In your capacity as the President of South Africa, we say, thank you, Comrade, for the solidarity that you've shown to Zimbabwe at the World Economic Forum. What you did at the World Economic Forum shows the mark of a true Pan-Africanist, shows the mark of a true great African leader. To the comments that were made by our brother, our fellow socialist, we say to you, Comrade Julius Malema, in light of all the statements that you have said, we share the same vision when it comes to African unity. We share the same vision when it comes to African development. We share the same vision to see the youth of Africa being emancipated out of poverty. But we think, out of some of the statements that you made at your press conference yesterday, some of them were misinformed in regard to what's happening in Zimbabwe. Not to disrespect you in any way, but we think your statements were more informed from the media, not on the facts on the ground. The stairway which happened last week was an instigation of the MDC. The stairway that happened last week was an act of terror. The stairway that happened last week was by no means innocent or civil. What we saw on Monday the 14th of January, it was a clear attempt on the state. What we saw on Monday the 14th of January was a clear instigation of the MDC alliance, instigating against our school kids that were taken out of their community on buses, you know, instructed to go back home, not to go to school. What we saw were workers from our various parastatals, from the private sector, from the public sector, being told not to go to work, to push a political agenda. It was nothing innocent. The MDC Alliance councillor for Borodo was arrested for instigating the violence in Redcliffe. The MDC Alliance came out in support of these things. If I could quote maybe an MDC Alliance activist, a Patson Zamara, who was clear on his agenda to see the people in the streets, who was clear on advocating for people to demonstrate against the government. And we say, Comrade Malema, we'd like to invite you to come to Zimbabwe and see the amount of damage that happened during the protest. We saw shops being looted. We saw people being beaten up. We saw violent hooligans that were armed. These are things that are not African. As in your way, if I'm to quote you well, in terms of what you said, this is barbaric. Barbaric in what way? Because we are destroying the Africa that we are trying to build. We are destroying an Africa for the generation that's coming. We are destroying an Africa for ourselves because we are the young who are going to lead tomorrow. So what kind of Africa do you want to inherit if we inherit a culture of looting? If you inherit a culture of people not wanting to work, but people actually want to instigate violence so that they acquire something out of it? To the issue of the internet shutdown, of course, the decision might have been painful, but if you ask the Zimbabweans on the ground, they know the situation, what was going on. There was peddling of fake news. There was instigation through the social media. There was clear mobilization of hooligans through social media. So certainly, these things, they warrant an internet shutdown. As painful as it may, we think these things, as patriotic Zimbabweans, they were very key in terms of safeguarding the state and the security of our nation. On the issue of you not being married to ZANU-PF, we did not take offense in that. Why? Because, you know, ZANU-PF has inspired many across the African continent, including the EFF. The policy that you're pushing for, land expropriation without compensation, it's a by-in large product of ZANU-PF, the land reform that happened in 1999 to 2000. These are things that we've seen benefit the African youth. These are things that we've seen benefit the African elderly. These are things that we've seen benefit the infants that are just being born, that are being born into an Africa that owns the land. Why am I saying so? We now have so many young farmers in Zimbabwe. So many people are now emancipated out of poverty through the land reform. These are things that we want to see South Africa going forward. And we are offering our solidarity to Zimbabwe. When you finally decide to act on the land, you must know that Zimbabwe is in support of whatever that you're going to be doing. Comrade Malema, let me also give you a hint on how successful we have been as a nation in terms of the Land Reform Act. We have seen the issue of black empowerment being championed out of land reform. We have seen the fight against white monopoly capital in Zimbabwe being championed out of the land reform program. Now we see black Zimbabweans being proud of who they are. Now we see black Zimbabweans walking the talk in terms of black emancipation within the context of Africa. These are things that we want to see happening in South Africa. So I call on you, fellow student leaders within the confines of South Africa, fellow political leaders within the confines of South Africa, fellow civic society organizations within the context of South Africa to endorse and support the issue of land. The land belongs to the black man. The land belongs to Africans. The land belongs to the original inhabitants of this motherland we call Africa. In regards to the comments you made of not giving money to ZANU-PF, certainly, I think these issues are best left for the corridors of diplomacy. Why do I say so? The bilateral relations between South Africa and Zimbabwe, they've been at their strongest since the coming in of the new dispensation. We do not want to tarnish the work that has been put in so far between our two presidents, Comrade D.D. Mnangagwa and Comrade Cyril Ramaphosa. Also, if you so much love the people of Zimbabwe, like you say, is it not best for you as a leader of the EFF to consider the people that voted for ZANU-PF when you make your comments? Are you saying you're clever than them? Are you saying you have a better understanding of the Zimbabwean situation than the people of Zimbabwe themselves that voted for President Mnangagwa and the ZANU-PF party? I think what we need to see is how ZANU-PF has managed to keep Zimbabwe standing under serious economic sanctions since the year 2000. If you look at post-independence South Africa, you haven't gone what you've gone through. You haven't gone through trade embargoes from the IMF. You haven't gone through not getting money from the World Bank. You haven't gone through not being able to sell your diamonds and gold in Belgium like we have. But here we are, as Zimbabweans, we still stand proud and tall amongst Africans. We actually compete in terms of the best educated country in Africa. So certainly these are things that have happened through the economic policies and social policies of ZANU-PF being in power. What we are praying for as young revolutionaries is to see the EFF and the ANC coming together under the banner of Pan-Africanism, coming together under the banner of togetherness, coming together under the banner of building a South Africa that's going to be stronger. Also, going forward, we'd like you to continue in your advocacy for African unity, to continue in your advocacy of issues that concern Zimbabwe. Certainly, we are one. Like you've always said, Africa cannot be divided. Africa is one. Going forward, we know you're going through a process of elections. We wish you all the best. We wish the ANC the best as well. Because as fighters in the struggle of black empowerment, together, the ANC and the EFF are our brothers. In the fight against white monopoly capital, the ANC and the EFF are our brothers. In the fight for land expropriation without compensation, the ANC and the EFF are our brothers. Aluta continua. Moi comrade moi. Victory is certain. Africa will rise again. Africa shall be the best in our lifetime. Thank you.